very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 11th October, on the front page you have trade border dispute likely to dominate Modi-Z talks. So this is regarding the informal summit taking place in Chennai and Mamallapuram visit. So here it is said no joint statement would be issued. MOUs and agreements are expected after informal summit, not presently. So trade and border dispute are likely to dominate the talks, you can see. So reducing bilateral trade deficit, which we have a trade deficit with China. We want market access for Indian companies in China, and for Huawei in 5G trials is what China is demanding. And also free trade agreement negotiations which are going on RCEP, Regional Comprehensive Economic Partnership. In this, China is also a member. So talks about that would be held. Then after the informal summit, it is said that special representatives of both the countries on border talks and on trade, informal summit, after that meetings of even trade ministers would take place. Another thing is there is this counter-terror exercise which India and China conduct together, which is called Hand in Hand. So this will be held in December. Also, one more point which is highlighted is India-China plus one. So this means that two countries, India and China together, working in a third country. So India-China plus one here is regarding diplomat training in Afghanistan. So that would also be extended with India-China plus one. Also, joint projects for capacity building in other countries would be discussed. And then this is BCIM corridor project, which would also be on agenda. Bangladesh, China, India, Myanmar infrastructure project, which has not seen any progress for a long time. It's a very old project, BCIM corridor. Then this is government moves to reopen JNK for high-end winter tourists. So Jammu and Kashmir government has decided to withdraw August 2 advisory asking tourists to leave the valley. So we should remember, before the decision to revoke Article 317 of the Constitution in Jammu and Kashmir, the government had issued advisory. That was on August 5 when 370 was revoked. On August 2, Jammu and Kashmir government had issued an advisory that foreign tourists, actually all tourists, should leave Kashmir Valley. And reason for that being given was security issues, security reasons. It was considered that a terror attack or terrorist threat or insurgents would be attacking or causing chaos in Kashmir. So that's why tourists were asked to leave the valley on August 2. And now Jammu and Kashmir government has decided, after Article 370 has been revoked, and that's what was going to happen. So the high value foreign tourists who visit the state during winter to enjoy skiing and adventure sports, they would be allowed to come back. So that advisory has been revoked. Then below you have Assam tea estates violate labor laws. So this is a report by Oxfam, which is a confederation of independent charitable organizations focusing on alleviation of global poverty. So they have flagged violation of labor rights in the tea estates in Assam. So tea estates here, there are concerns raised, like tea plantation workers have no toilets, they live in crumbling houses, wages are very low, there is lack of quality health and education entitlements. So along with this, Oxfam India has conducted research and has provided this report addressing the human cost of Assam tea. And this is like Ranbaxy promoters arrested. This is Economic Offences Wing of Delhi Police, which has arrested Ranbaxy's former promoters and three others on allegations of cheating and diverting 2,397 crores as such of Religare Finvest Limited. Then below you have Moody's cuts India's financial year 2020 growth to 5.8%. So this is the credit rating agency Moody's Investor Services. So it has pegged India's GDP growth for the current financial year at 5.8%, which is lower than even RBI projection. RBI, we had seen few days back how it brought a growth projection for the present financial year from 6.9% to 6.1%. Moody's has taken it down to 5.8%. So India's growth in the first quarter of present financial year was very low at 5%. So that had even made RBI bring down its growth projection for the year, and now it's moody. Then this is regarding Literature Nobel Prize. So 2019 Nobel Prize for Literature has been awarded, and there are two awardees, one for 2019, and since in 2018 there was no Literature Nobel Prize awarded because of a controversy in the panel. So two Nobel Prizes have been awarded, one for 2019, one for 2018. So 2019 winner is Austrian novelist and playwright Peter Handke, and 2018 winner is Polish writer Olga Tokarczuk. And regarding even Peter Handke, it is written, like in his novel Die Obst Diabin, the young heroine is unaware of the strange fortune she is expecting. So his novel, it is said, is characterized by strong adventurous spirit and also nostalgia. And here in her book, it is written in her book, like, best work is considered to be the historical novel The Books of Jacob. Then this is India slams Turkey for Syria action. So India has described Turkey's military action in Syria as unilateral and has asked it to respect Syria's territorial integrity and sovereignty. So, we have seen how US has withdrawn from Syria, and Turkey has now started assaulting northern Syria, which is its southern border. So it is targeting the Kurdish rebels. So the Kurdish rebels were actually the ones who had supported USA in its war against Islamic State, and after US withdrew suddenly, which has caused protests, which has caused concerns being raised even in USA, the Kurdish rebels, which were allies of USA, are now left without any support, and Turkey has started its assault here. Then on page 2 you have, after denied clearance, Kejriwal to address C40 via video conference. So we had seen regarding the C40 climate change summit, which was to take place, which is taking place in Denmark, in Copenhagen. So the Minister of External Affairs did not provide clearance to Delhi Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal to visit this event, and he was scheduled to address here. So now the Chief Minister would address session titled Breathe Deeply, City Solutions for Clean Air through video conference. And this is 12 hotels in South Delhi given Swachh Sarvekshan rankings. So this is, you can see, based on their sanitation facilities, waste segregation and toilet facilities and cleanliness, they have been given Swachh Sarvekshan rankings. The municipal body says that this initiative is taken to inculcate healthy competition. On page 8 you have Malappuram Bank given one more chance to approve amalgamation. So RBI has given nod to the government of Kerala to set up its own bank. So 13 district cooperative banks will be merged with Kerala State Cooperative Bank to form Kerala's largest banking network. So the government has claimed that the objective is to strengthen the cooperative sector, but opposition in Kerala says that it would destroy the traditional cooperative sector. So this is regarding how Malappuram district, also all the district cooperative banks except one in Malappuram district controlled by opposition, have approved the left government's proposal of amalgamation. Then below you have invasive weeds threatening tiger habitats in Adilabad. So here you should know how invasive weeds can affect the population of herbivores. And herbivores, if their population is affected, then they are prey to the big cat, tigers. So their population would also be affected. So how the food chain works. So it is said, it was way back in 1992 at Rio de Janeiro Convention on Biodiversity, that biological invasion of alien species of plants was recognized as the second worst threat to the environment after habitat destruction. But it is said nothing much has been done, and here also this concern has been raised about invasive weeds. On page 9 you have this detailed report of Oxfam, which says that Assam's tea estates are having labor law violations. So it says that states move to provide living wages to the workers should be supported. So this is a detailed coverage on that, about various countries and how their supermarkets and tea brands share percentage is, and number of workers percentage as such, and share of end consumer price required by workers to enable a living wage. So that is shown here, you can see. On the editorial page, the first editorial is a Chennai setting. So this is regarding Modi's e-summit, which is going to take place in Chennai and Mamallapuram. So it is said this summit might restore the Bonhomian ties that saw strains recently. So we have trade disputes, border disputes, even Kashmir related dispute with respect to China-Pakistan relations. And the second editorial is Going Down Together. So this is regarding IMF warning, International Monetary Fund. It says the world must heed the IMF warning that everyone loses in a trade war. The lead article in Mamallapuram, seeking the true north in ties. So our ties should escalate, go north, go high. So for that, this India-China informal summit is discussed. It is said it is another opportunity for both leaders to reset relations in an era of geostrategic flux. So various points, important points on this are discussed, like on Kashmir issue and also in the global context, in the context of US-China trade war going on and targeting Huawei, such concerns are also there. And this is, it is still an amber light for road safety. So this says, in spite of ambitious provisions in the amended motor vehicles law, safe road behavior is still miles away. So that is a concern. So though the penalties have been increased, still road safety is a concern. Then on op-ed page on Fridays, you have parley coverage. So here a question is tried to be answered. The question is, do we need a countrywide NRC, National Register of Citizens? So we saw the NRC process concluded in Assam, and final NRC list has been published, though what further steps will be taken has to be seen. So there are such claims being made, and even the Home Ministry has given statement that NRC like exercise would be conducted all across the country to detect illegal migrants and deport them. But then illegal migrants to be deported, the other country should accept them. They should have documents to prove their citizenship of other country. Only then that is possible. Otherwise, they cannot be hung in the middle. They could not be left for nowhere. So this is there. On page 12, you have Sinha panel to review economy first. So this is regarding Parliamentary Committee on Finance, which has BJP members in majority and is chaired by ruling party's former minister Jayant Sinha. So this Parliamentary Committee on Finance has agreed to discuss the state of economy as the first subject to be taken up at its meeting on October 17. So this will be the main topic. Other likely topics are efficacy of the overall taxation framework, financing the innovation ecosystem, performance and regulation of capital markets, etc. So members of the Parliamentary Committee on Finance want a comprehensive review of RBI covering its structure, function, mandate and role. So focus is on RBI decision to transfer 1.76 lakh crore of its reserve funds to the union government. Then on page 13, you have two summits contrasting optics. So this is a news analysis on the two summits, one at Wuhan last year and now Mamallapuram summit presently. So that is discussed, contrasting the two summits. And this is panel set up to expedite privatization of trains. So the Ministry of Railways has constituted an empowered group of secretaries to work on development of 50 railway stations as well as handing over operations of 150 trains to private operators. So Niti Aayog CEO Amitabh Kant's letter to Railway Board Chairman pointed out the delay in railways project for developing 400 stations. So now you can see this empowered group of secretaries has been formed to expedite the process. On international page, you have thousands flee Turkey's attack in Syria. So at least 23 Kurdish fighters and 8 civilians have been killed and over 60,000 people have been displaced. So this is northern Syria, where Turkey is proposing a safe zone extending 30 kilometers into Syria. And this campaign which is going on, Turkey lies up here. So campaign which is going on here is actually resulting in a humanitarian crisis. 60,000 people have been displaced. So this is Saudi Arabia now allows women to join armed forces. So the kingdom is pushing reforms to improve image and woo tourists. And this is Apple removes app used by Hong Kong protesters. So when Google has dropped a game from its store, so Apple removed this app which helped Hong Kong protesters track police movements. So it was said it was used by the protesters to ambush law enforcement. So there was sharp criticism by a Chinese state newspaper, and Apple has decided to bar hkmap.live.app. So which it actually crowdsources the locations of both police and protesters. So that has been removed. And also Google, it is said, has dropped a game from its store. As such, on business page you have GST Council sets up panel to spur collection. So in light of falling GST revenues, GST Council Secretariat has set up a committee of central and state tax officers to look into wide range of reforms to boost revenue collection. And on the last page you have, scientists create customized drug for girl with brain disease. So Millicent is said to be the first tailor-made treatment for a single patient. So this is a new drug created to treat just one patient. And you know, this is personalized medicine now, first custom treatment for a genetic disease. It is called Milasen. It is named after the only patient who will be ever taking it, Mila Magovic. So she lives with her mother in USA. She's 8 years old and she has a rapidly progressing neurological disorder that is fatal. So this is a medicine made for her. And this is post-scandal Swedish Academy Awards 2 Nobel Literature Prizes. So we saw this on front page. This is a detailed coverage on Nobel Prize for Literature. So that is it. These are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website aasha.com and even download the current affairs PDF. Thank you.